Welcome back, everyone. We are going to learn today about dividing decimals. Please, again, do not panic about this division. Division is just you thinking about your multiplication backwards. So, no panicking, staying calm, and using what we do know to solve what we don't know. Notes are ready. Here we go. We're going to look at dividing decimals, both dividing decimals by a whole number, and then dividing by a decimal as well. So we're going to start with the easier of the two and dividing by a whole number. So our first step when dividing a decimal number by a whole number is that we are going to place the decimal point directly above the decimal under the division bracket. Step two, find the quotient. So those are kind of vague steps, but remember that when you're dividing and you see it this way, 94 hundredths divided by 3, you put the first number underneath the division bracket, and the other number is on the outside. Think you're trying to figure out how many times 3 goes into 94 hundredths, okay? So then we set it up, and then it says to place the decimal point directly above. So it goes right there. And now we're going to divide as normal, okay? So 3 goes into 0, 0 times. 3 goes into 9, though, 3 times. So then you go 3 times 3 is 9. See if there's any left over. 9 minus 9 is 0. Bring down our 4. 3 goes into 4 1 time. 1 times 3 is 3. With 1 remaining. Fill in zeros and bring them down. Three goes into 10, 3 times. 3 times 3 is 9. That's 1 left over. Bringing down a 0. Oh, we have 10 again. Well, goes in there 3 times. 9. Notice we're going to have a pattern here. This is going to keep happening. We're going to keep getting a remainder of 1. So we know that that 3 is just going to keep repeating. So what we can say is, the quotient, the answer to the division problem of 94 hundredths divided by 3, is 0 and 313 with 3 repeating thousandths. Okay? So that 3, this is called bar notation. And that shows that that number, notice it's only over the 3 because that 3 is the only number that continues to repeat. Okay, so bar notation shows a repeating decimal. All right, try the next one. Maybe try setting it up on your own. So which one goes in the division bracket is the one that comes first, 94 and 21 hundredths divided by 6. Bring my decimal directly up. 6 goes into 9. Let's see, 1 time. 1 times 6 is 6. Can subtract. What's the difference? It's 3. Bring down my 4. 6 goes into 34. 5 times. 5 times 6 is 30. Bring down, subtract. 4 minus 0 is 4. And then bring down the next place value. Something that those of you that get a little messy, kind of like me, want to keep in mind is maybe using, either turning your notebook sideways or putting lines down before you start so you make sure you can keep your place values in line. Continuing on, so then we say, okay, 6 goes into 42 7 times. 7 times 6 is 42. Remainder of 0. We can't stop there, though, because we still have this place value 1 to bring down. Well, 6 doesn't go into 1, so put a 0 up there. Same 0, 0. So we have that 1 come down again, fill in with a 0. We have 10. 6 goes into 10 once. Subtract 6. We get a remainder of 4. Bring down a 0. 6 goes into 40 6 times. 6 times 6 is 36. And here's where you're going to start seeing that repeating pattern again. We're going to always have a remainder of 4. So you're going to see that that's remainder And then we're going to have that 6 is going to continue to repeat. So your quotient is this, remembering your bar notation there. Some of you are going to get 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, and then you could say rounding up, and some of you will write it out as 15, 7, 1, 6, and then some of you might be like, oh, it eventually rounds. I guess depending on what the directions would tell you to do, you'd keep that in mind. Okay, now dividing a decimal by a decimal. Not much different, just we are essentially trying to get the number we're dividing by, that outside number, to be a whole number. Okay? So we're going to move the decimal points to the right, the same number of places, to make the outside number whole. And then the steps are the same as before. So for example, I put in 12 and 6 tenths, and that's getting divided by 3 tenths. Well, 3 tenths isn't a whole number. I like to think of this step as my skip, hop step. Because I'm skipping the number over, so I skip this number over, and then I hop it up to where it would go. Skip, skip, hop. Then I divide as normal. 3 goes into 12. 4 times, with a difference of 0, bring down my 6, 3 goes into 6, 2 times, with none remaining, and that can just be written as a difference of, or a quotient of 42, which makes sense. It seems silly, because 14 divided by, we're cutting this 12.6 into tiny, tiny pieces. So if you cut something into tiny pieces, you're going to have more pieces. And we'll give a visual of that in class. So again, and then trying this one, we want to skip, skip, hop first. So we skip, 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 and then we're going to hop it up to the same place. Remember, if you're going to be messy, you might want to go and make yourself some lines so you make sure you keep those place values intact. So now I'm going to divide as normal. So I do 236 is what I'm looking at here. Goes into 264 one time. Then I subtract. Hit 28, bring down my 3. 236 is going to go into 283 also once. Notice, got to keep that in mind what place I'm in so I don't put that on the wrong side of the decimal. And I subtract again, and I get 47, bring down my 2. Here's where I'm going to kind of, okay, I don't know exactly, but I'm going to do, I know that 36 times 30, plus 36 is 72, and 2 and 2 is 4, so I can assume that this twice, or times 2, is 472, and it is. So 236 goes into 472 twice with none remaining. So your quotient is 11 and 2 tenths. Very last one, if you're feeling confident, go ahead and pause, try it, and come back and check. So I'm going to skip, skip, hop. Then I don't know 15 into 83 that well, so I'm going to estimate. I'm going to guess first. 15, let's say, times 6. So we get 0, 3, 90. So it doesn't go in there quite 6 times, so maybe one less. Goes in there 5 times for 75. Notice how I just use my multiplication to help me with division. So then I have a difference of 8. Bring down my 2. Again, I'm getting messy, so for you it might be helpful to do those lines to keep everything in order, and that's going to go in there again 5 times for 75. 7 left over, we know it goes in there 5 times with none left over. So the quotient of 83 and 25 hundredths divided by 1.5 is 55.5. So ladies and gentlemen, make sure you are comfortable with the steps, you are careful with your note-taking, and then you come to class with questions. See you soon.